problems, especially with women. And in the end, nakipagrelasyon siya because siguro si Delilah super beauty talaga, no? And end of the day, nascam si Samson. Nascam sa ni Delilah. She sold him out to the Philistines, and in the end, he even lost his eyesight because of it. So sa mga lalaki dyan, pag mahilig kayo sa mga Delilah, mahirap na yon, baka mawala din yung mga mata. No? At sa mga na-in love, be careful with the scam. Kahit si Samson, ha? Na scam. Na? Especially ngayon sa buhay natin, na dami ng mga fake news. No? Makinig ka lang sa mga balita, especially sa mga TV patrol or sa ating sa Pilipinas, maraming mga love scam. No? Maraming mga pagkukunwari, and then end of the day, niloloko ka lang. No? So kahit si Samson, ganun kalakas, he has also faith, yet he was scammed. No? He was betrayed, he was sold out to the Philistines, at yun nga, tingnan mo si Samson, yung mata niya wala na. He lost his eyesight. Kaya siya nag-pray ng ganito in Judges 16:28-30 na sana bigyan pa sana ng one more chance, no, to get this revenge, no? Then Samson reached toward the two central pillars, picture na yan, huh? On which the temple stood, bracing himself against them, his right hand on the one and on his left hand on the other, Samson said, "Let me die with the Philistines." Then he pushed with all his might, and down came the temple of the rulers and all the people in it. Thus he killed many more when he died than while he lived. So anong matutunan natin dito? Anong matutunan natin kay Samson? Firstly, na matutunan natin, ang lahat na ginagawa nating masama, hindi kaya-aya sa Panginoon, there is always a consequence. Kaya mas mabuti pa that you try to avoid this costly mistake. So sa mga lalaki, before you choose your partner, do not be like Samson na hindi mo pakilala dahil maganda lang siya or iba yung beauty niya. Ay, ito na siguro yung sa akin. No? Huwag yung random lover lang, no? That you barely know. Iba yun pag he is or she is with the Lord. Pero kahit na gumawa si Samson plenty of mistakes, God can still use him for his glory. Kaya minsan tayo, we fall into mistakes several times, few times, araw-araw, but remember, God is with us. God will steal you for his glory. Kaya this is what happened. God still give him that strength, and he was able to finish strong. Kaya mga kapatid, minsan nagkasala tayo, meron pa rin tayong mga ginagawang masama, it's not too late. Come back to the Lord. Sa mga getting married or getting have that kind of relationship, please be careful with the people who you do not know. It is preferable that you choose the right mate with the same faith that you have. Kasi sabi sa 2 Corinthians 6:14, do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness, and what communion has light with darkness? Hindi pwede pagsamahin yung masama at mabuti. and what accord does Christ with Belial? Or what part does a believer with an unbeliever? Choosing a partner is very important. Choose someone with the same faith that you have. Okay ba sa mga dalaga at sa mga binata dyan? Amen. Okay. Tingnan na natin si Daniel kung ano nating anong matutunan natin kay Daniel. Daniel naman, he's, titingnan mo sa photo dyan, he's a very prayerful guy, you know? He did always what was right, even to the risk of having death. Daniel is one of those na mga katulad ni Joseph, no? They are very, or he is very diligent of doing you what is right, anong tama, kahit minsan it can be a personal risk. Kung naalala nyo, itong si Daniel, saan sa pinasok, saan siya nilagay nang hindi siya, hindi niya sinunod yung order?
Lion's den.
Lion's den. Hmm. He's a prayerful guy, pero dahil hindi niya sinunod yung utos, he will be thrown into the lion's den. Ano? Ipakain sa leon? Gusto niyo ba ninyong maranasan ipakain kayo sa leon? Huh? But what did Daniel do? He continued to pray instead na manghina sa, he continued to pray to the Lord just like normal, parang walang nangyayari. Kaya tayo minsan when we are in a very tough situation, do not let that situation drag us down. But instead, keep on trusting the Lord, keep on praying like normal ang situation. Anong ginawa ni Daniel? He went home to his upstairs room. 3 times a day, he got down on his knees. Right? 3 times a day, he would got up on his knees and prayed, giving thanks to God just as he had done before. Ito yung ginagawa ni Daniel. May special trip si Daniel, no? One-way ticket towards the lion den. But God had other plans, kaya hindi siya nasaktan. The angel was sent to shut the lion's mouth, and it did not hurt him, and he was proven to be innocent in the sight. So, mga kapatid, minsan meron tayong mga pupuntahan o may nangyayari sa ating buhay, let God shut the lion's mouth. Let God be full of cool control. Ito, kahit prayerful pala tayo, may mga nangyayari din na minsan na hindi natin gusto. But God is in control. God will take full control pa rin sa buhay natin. Dito makikita natin that Daniel won the victory not because of his strength nor of his ability, but because it is God who made it happen. So sa mga nangyayari sa ating buhay, He is still to be praised. He is still in full control no matter what. Kaya whether you are faithful and prayerful, may mga nangyayari na hindi natin gusto. But, sa sinasabi ko na, a good thing for us believers, we have the Lord Jesus Christ that is in us. Okay? Lakpakan naman natin ang Panginoon. What a wonderful God we serve. Tingnan naman natin si Job, no? Kagabi sana sabihin ko kay Brother Albert, huwag na to kasi nasa sermon ko na yan eh. Kaya lang, it happened for a reason, okay? Ito si Job. He is a man of faith. Pero yung suffering na nangyari sa kanya, hindi hamak. Sobra-sobra. Lost his animals. Lost his children. Even his health. Pero, Job did not curse God. He still gave his praises to God. Tayo ba? Ano namang klaseng buhay to? Ayan na naman, no? And say, Lord, thank you, thank you. Hindi natin kaya gawin, no? But look at this Job. With all the things that has happened to him, he still is faithful to God. Job was a man of faith. Tayo din, no? We are children of faith. Minsan akala natin yung mga faithful are having entitled of good things. And how about bad things? Bad things happen too. No? Hindi pwede na lahat ng gusto natin ay mga, minsan may mga nangyari hindi natin gusto. But God will not abandon you. Because of your faith to Him, because of His love for you, He will not abandon you. And God is true in His word. It will be there forever and ever. No? Sabi pa ni Job sa nangyari na yan. Naked I came. Word natin. From my mother's womb and naked I will depart. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. May the name of the Lord be praised. In all this, Job did not sin by charging God with wrongdoing. Keeping that faith in God. This is the big measure. This is the biggest advantage that we have because of that faith in God. Even sometimes life doesn't make change, doesn't make sense. Kasi nakala natin, wala nang kabuluhan ng buhay. But it is that faith that is holding us up to trust the Lord. Okay ba tayo? Marami tayong natutunan. Praise the Lord. Okay. Pupunta na doon sa main. Introduction pa lang yun. Ha? How to grow your faith in time of adversity. Sabi sa Hebrews 11:1, faith shows the reality of what we hope for. It is the evidence of things we cannot see. NLT, this is NLT version. Ano daw? Shows the reality of what we hope for. We hope for what? Huh? It is the evidence of things we cannot see. What things we cannot see? Huh? Ito, it is simply a firm persuasion and expectation that God will perform all what He has promised through Christ. Lahat na nag-promise sa through Christ, it will be done. Oh, simple as that. Just have faith in God. Have faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Because without faith,